Today, I'm going to take a look at a feature that I think a lot of you have been waiting for, and that's ZFS RAIDZ expansion. You can finally take an existing RAIDZ array of, let's say, 4 drives and just add a 5th drive and get the additional capacity of that 5th drive added to your pool. Overall, it's a pretty painless process, but today I'm going to take a look at how it actually performs and works on my test benches, go through the interface of how it can be performed, do a little bit of performance testing to see how long it takes to add that additional drive, and then do a little bit of an explanation of what's going on under the hood in ZFS. ZFS, since its creation, has had a limitation that once you make a RAID Z, which is roughly equivalent to a RAID 5 or RAID 6 array of, let's say, 4 drives, it's fixed. You can't just add a 5th or 6th drive to the array. You can't convert its type. It's just there. You could delete it and make a new one, but for a lot of home server users like me, buying another set of drives to store your data and copy it to is a lot of additional costs that many people don't want to have. And while it may be recommended to people to just buy the bigger array that they might think they want to need, again, with home users with limited budgets, paying for more drives and more ports to use those drives can be a lot of additional money. So being able to just add an additional drive later on is a really nice feature for many, especially home and low budget users. And it's really nice to see that they finally released this feature and it's getting into stable releases now. Now, a few caveats before starting this process is that your array needs to be in a nice, stable online state before doing anything. If you have drives that are offline or having issues, you need to replace or fix those problems before you can start doing any RAIDZ expansion. The other thing is you'll likely need to update your ZFS software and upgrade your pool to be able to support RAIDZ expansion. ZFS expansion is basically only supported in the latest releases as of now, like TrueNAS 24.10 Electric Eel, so you need to update your TrueNAS install and then go and run the zpool upgrade your pool name to add those additional features to the pool. And that'll upgrade the metadata to the latest version so that you can perform the expansion process. This shouldn't result in any issues or any downtime, but the one disadvantage it means is now that your ZFS pool is now a newer version, it can't be mounted on older systems. So if you want to recover the data or mount it on another system, it has to be running that same version of ZFS on the other system or a newer release to be able to take advantage to it. And now that you have an upgraded ZFS pool and everything is online and ready to go, you can use the zpool attach drive in the command line to just add additional drives to the pool. So the command would look like zpool attach pool name, the RAID Z name. So if you run something like ZFS status, you'll see something like RAID Z1-0-1, for example, and so on, depending on how large your pool is. So that's telling it what actual RAID Z vdev the drive should be added to. And then you run the device name that you want to add to the pool. So for example, something like /dev/disk-byid, and then the full device of the name is typically the recommended path to add the drive to the pool. I'd also typically suggest running this with -in first, which means dry run. So it'll show you what the pool will look like before running the actual command, so you don't accidentally add it to the wrong RAID Z or do something weird and can kind of double check your work before it's actually written to the pool. And then once it's written, it's going to start moving the data around in the pool so you have more additional space on all of the drives. If you're using something like TrueNAS, you can go under the pools, see a list of RAID Zs on it, click on one of those, say extend, and then select from one of the unused drives on your system. I did this just fine in TrueNAS using the GUI and the command line, but it seems like there's a bug in the current version of TrueNAS where it will just be stuck on the prompt of adding, but it shows it as added in the command prompt, and if I reload the web page, it works just fine with the device added. Now, when it comes to the actual performance and amount of time taken to add the drive, it was a lot longer than I'd expect using purely sequential data copies. For all of my testing, I was using WD-RED 4TB drives, which run at a maximum of about 100 to 200 megabytes per second in sequential workloads. And I was seeing about 40 megabytes using the extend command, adding more drives. And as I'll explain later, this is likely due to the fact that ZFS is using a lot of non-sequential workloads when it adds more drives, causing mechanical hard drives to do this much slower than they'd otherwise be capable of in a truly sequential workflow. So in my testing, I took a 4-drive RAID Z1 using those 4TB WD-RED drives with about 540 gigabytes of data allocated and added a 5th drive. That took about 1 hour and 20 minutes. I then added a sixth drive. It was a little bit faster at 1 hour and 15 minutes. Added a seventh drive at about 1 hour and 10 minutes. And adding an eighth drive took about 1 hour total. So those speed estimates are definitely a bit slower than what the drives are capable of at their max sequential speeds, but far from slow enough to cause any substantial issues. Unfortunately though, this means if you are using drives that have performance issues with a lot of random I/O, like SMR drives, this is likely going to cause major performance issues and will take much longer. I also want to note that while I didn't have any issues performing ZFS RAIDZ expanding, I generally like to recommend to make a backup of your system first or have a plan for the worst case scenario, something like file system corruption, anytime you're doing a RAID expansion or major changes to how your disks are laid out, just in case. I like to take it the safe side, so I'm ready for the worst case scenario, even though that is going to likely be very unlikely with any of these expansion jobs. One disadvantage with how RAIDZ expansion works is that it doesn't rewrite the parity for its existing data blocks. It just spreads out those data and parity blocks across the additional drive. And what this means in practice is you will have a little bit less usable space if you take a RAIDZ pool and extend it than if you were to start with that original larger RAIDZ pool or use something like RAID 5 and RAID 6 expansion, which will typically give you the full available amount of space. As a quick example, if I had four drives of, let's say, 1 terabyte each that were completely full, I would have 3 terabytes of data if in a RAID Z1 configuration and 1 terabyte of parity. If I then decided to go add an additional 1 terabyte drive to make it a 5-drive RAID Z1 that has been expanded, I will still have 3 terabytes of data and 1 terabyte of parity. It's just now going to be spread across 5 drives instead of 4. So now instead of each drive being full with 1 terabyte of data, each drive will now have 0.8 terabytes of data used. In comparison, if I was to rewrite all that data or use a more traditional RAID 5 or RAID 6 expansion, that would use about 0.75 terabytes of drive data on each drive. So you are losing a little bit of space on existing data. One workaround for this is if you move data away from it and then copy new data to that now expanded RAID Z pool, it will copy it to it using the full width and taking the most advantage of the drive space you have. There are a lot of cool white papers online of how OpenZFS has implemented it, but I'm going to try to explain it a little bit on my blackboard to get a better feel of what's going on under the hood. So in my example here, I have a very small array of, let's say, 4 drives here, each of which has drive data like 1, 2, and 3. And they have their parity trunks here, and the rest of these A, B, and C trunks are going to be data. So in this case, I am going to go and add a 5th drive right here. A more traditional RAID setup would effectively move the parity to a new drive and then find some other data to make this 1D of data. But RAIDZ expansion doesn't do that. It keeps this 1P exactly the same, and then it moves 2A down here and nudges all of this data forward. So like 2B would go here, and then 2P would get moved forward, and then 2D is going to stay here and move forward. So now there's 2 free chunks on these last 2 drives, and 3A and 3B will get moved down, giving you more additional space on those additional drives as everything gets nudged over. And what this means in practice is my 3 available chunks of data, instead of being on that new drive, are now spread out across all the drives so I can write more data to all of it. Check out the white paper. It's a nice read if you want to find out more of what's going on under the hood here. But I think it's interesting to kind of know what the data solutions are doing under the hood to find out why they have these limitations of slightly less usable space. And I did my testing expanding a 4-drive RAID Z1 all the way up to 8 drives, and I saw exactly my expected amount of data and parity utilization on all of those drives. In general, I would say this is not a huge limitation for most use cases, as it's not that much more space with most reasonable configurations of RAID Z, RAID Z2, and RAID Z3. One other slight limitation that there is in ZFS is that it isn't really rewriting the metadata, but it's more so making a pointer to the new locations after it's expanded the data. Now, I didn't see any performance issues in my 4 drives that has been expanded 3 times into 8, but it's a technically not optimal setup in terms of how it has to handle metadata. but practically it probably doesn't matter in most home situations. And I think this brings me to the conclusion of this video. I think it's really awesome to see ZFS adding any of these new features, and especially RAIDZ expansion, as it's one thing I've heard multiple people say, I don't want to use ZFS because of it, and now it's here. So if you had to previously debate between using ZFS features and having the ability to expand parity array, now you no longer have to worry about that. There are some technical limitations, but I don't think they're a big issue for most home users, where being able to just add an additional drive is going to be a much bigger feature add than the slight possible limitations. If I have the budget and resources, I'd still get the big array and just immediately start with it if I can, but I know that's not a thing for everyone, and it's great to see they've added software here. Let me know if you've expanded your array already, or if you're planning to in the future, or any other comments or thoughts you have with RAIDZ expansion in the comments below. I'm looking forward to taking a read to them, and thanks for watching this video. Also, I'm giving the YouTube memberships thing a try, so check the join button down below if you want to take a look at some BTS content, help me decide on what future videos are going to be about, and watch some of these new videos a little bit early. Thanks for watching and supporting the channel.